A look at some other stuff that I've been doing off stream, including this big lad here. This is the Master Grade Aegis Gundam, and I actually started this last year, at the end of last year, kind of right before all the ball drop madness, but ended up getting distracted with many other things, including the holidays and all of that jazz. So here we are now. Yesterday I kind of thought we might as well pick this back up and keep on working on it. Doku, how's it going, Doku? Nice to see you here. Yeah, just kind of going over some stuff that I've been doing off stream, including this. You know what? This design, as I was building it, I was not kind of on board. I wasn't fully sold on it. I was making it and was kind of like, yeah, this is kind of neat. This is fine. But because the way this is a transforming kit, right? And so a lot of parts have to be accommodated for like the other transformation mode. It kind of ends up being awkward, some of the build parts, some of the aspects of the process. But ultimately, I kind of like how it all looks all assembled, so good on Bandai for that. I was a doubter, but now I'm kind of on board. Look at this thing. I love this model, and like I said, I'm going to seek out another one, I think. It's just, this is my aesthetic. So, I was talking about this model. This was actually one of the first... This was one of the first models that I built this year in 2024, and it's the Glacier, the Transient Gundam Glacier. I really enjoyed this build. It's the first time I've really worked with quite a bit of clear parts. But that being said, it's a very different aesthetic than what I typically gravitate towards. If you look at a number of my models that I've built over the last year or two, a lot of them tend to be round in shape, ovoid in shape, a lot of smooth shapes. I like round stuff, guys. Give me those round stuff. Anything from the ball to Machining Krieger to Choo-Choo's Demi Trainer, Bulbasaur. Many of those models end up being very round in shape. But this here is a spiky boy, and that's not something that I typically gravitate towards. But that being said, I ended up really, really loving this model. And likewise, I also have this, which I've been working on off stream, another spiky boy. The Aegis Gundam, which we might come back to later today. This right here, I say all that to say this. This is peak Ipo Dempsey Roll aesthetic, guys. Look at this shit. I'm feeling it. Chunky and big on the back. Round, a lot of round shapes. Yes, give it to me. Anyways,